Protesting is when you act out in various ways against what you want changed or don't believe in. This is an example of a protest. The government will get backhanded. Hello, I'm Todd. So my good pal Elliot has an assignment for a language arts class at school, and he will be making a video for part of it explaining three or more protests that went on in Vietnam or U.S., and they were led by military or ex-military personnel. He will also be explaining who won the war and how it ended. Back to you, Elliot. Thanks, Todd, for that wonderful explanation. Around 1970, in Chile, 800 former members of the Corps issued a statement protesting against what was happening in Vietnam. Whichever one sounds better. I do say, and they must have been pretty unhappy with the war, along with many others. Take Daniel Ellsberg, for example. He was an ex-military Marine officer who released several confidential documents to the public, and they were known as the Pentagon Papers. I do say, he and his friend Anthony Russo released the 7,000-page document to several congressmen and the New York Times. Do elaborate and tell me where they printed all of this. Alright, I will elaborate and tell you where they printed all of them. They printed them at a friend's advertising agency. That's cool and all, but didn't they go to prison for that? Almost, but the judge called off the trial because of the Watergate events. Oh, I see. Well, this man was very brave. Yeah, he was. Almost as brave as Father Philip Barringer, who teamed up with Tom Lewis and David Eberhardt and James McGill and went to the office of a draft board in Baltimore and drenched the draft records in blood. Well, what makes this guy braver than the last dude? Well, after being sent to prison, the World War II veteran once again removes draft records from the same place with the help of his brother and seven other people. They took the records and set them on fire outside of the building. Oh, I see, yeah. That would take a lot of courage to do something like that. And then just wait to be arrested? La 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 la. Yes, my good sir. But we have a lot more to talk about. Let's meet up another time. Say 8 o'clock tomorrow. Oh, shizay. Hello? 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 Now where is he? We still need to discuss how the war ended and who won. If he doesn't show up, I'm gonna be extremely disappointed. Hello? Oh, there you are. Yes, I am here. Well, let's get started, shall we? Yes, indeed. Let's get started. The war mainly ended because of the French, the U.S. signing a French document saying that the war would end. But a lot of events led up to this, including many protests. In fact, that's mainly one of the reasons that the war ended, because of all the protests that were going on. Most of America was against the war, and a lot of other countries were too. And Nixon, I believe, was afraid of that because of all the protests, and he obviously didn't like it. And yeah, shucks. We entered the war to prevent the communist rule and to get rid of it. And here, let me change the English. And we did not succeed at that. The U.S. failed at that, which was the whole purpose of us joining the war and intervening into that battle. And we kind of just gave up. So that's kind of making me lean towards, you know, the U.S. lost. And also, we're the ones that retreated out of not wanting to lose any more American soldiers or slaughter any more innocent Vietnamese people. And the Vietnamese Like, Vietnam did not retreat the war. They didn't forfeit or give up. And also part of it was because of all the protesting and whatnot that was going on. With all the protests going on, the people thought it was wrong. So they ended the war in Vietnam. The war was gone. The war was gone. Process, bit of a little to making your names into a colossus. Believe me, I'm thankful my brother's still with me. And ain't much change, Bobby's still troubling with me. And Bush is still bombing poor people, yo, he's deadly. And me, I got a little recording game.